Hey everybody, my name is Kenny and you're watching Brave the Wilds on YouTube. So, I've decided to do a little bit of kit rearranging and changing my mentality, like I always do. It seems like, you always change your kit, you always upgrade your kit, you always do things to improve it. So I'm heading towards a more modular system, basically where I have certain levels of kit. So this right here is a new system that I've come up with, and I would consider it a base layer. Now, of course, it's very rough because I haven't totally finished up my kit yet. I've just kind of begun this modularizing system. But this is kind of what I've started with. And so I want to start with by saying my Alice Pack and my the medium Alice Pack that I normally carry, I've done several videos on it, is more of a longevity-centered kit. It has a lot of things in it that are meant for longer term. It's got conibers in there. It's got quite a few tools in there that are able to maintain you over the long term. So that's great, and I've done a lot of videos on that, but I figured I'd go ahead and do a video on a day pack kit. This is something that you would take in the morning and you'd come back that evening if you're just doing a day of bushcraft or light camping or something like that, something that you're not going to be there overnight, but it does have the ability to have a night out if you absolutely had to. This kit does not necessarily have a tarp in it because this is something that is very dependent on the weather because it is a day pack kit. If it was a long-term kit, it should not be dependent on the weather, what you put in it, because it should be able to sustain you through any type of weather condition. So it should have up to, cold weather, especially if it was a winter time. If it was the winter time, you would have cold weather gear in this 24/7 and rainy gear 24/7. But this is not what that kit is. This is a day pack kit. So since I've set this up to where it's not going to rain that day, and I know it's not going to rain, I only have a wool blanket. If I knew it was going to rain, I would carry a tarp. So I'll go ahead and start with the bottom. Actually, I guess I'll go ahead and start with by saying I have no idea what this pack actually is. It's a very small square pack. It's probably 10 by 10 by maybe 5 inches deep. It's a very square, very modular kind of system. This was given to me by Heavy B2U. I'll put a link in the description. I won a contest probably two, maybe even 3 years ago, but I think 2 years ago. And this is one of the gifts. They're not very expensive. I've looked them up. I've completely and totally forgotten the name. I think this is like a rainforest type pattern or something, but I really don't know much about it. All I know is it's a kit. And the reason I really like it is because it has a lot of waterproofing type things built into it. So that's the reason I chose it for this day pack kit. So on the bottom, I've just got a couple bungee cords. And that hold my bedroll and my axe here. Just my plum hatchet with the new handle on it that I showed you guys. And the sheath that I showed you how to make as well. And then I just have some steel core bungee cords. Now, I think it's important that you have steel core because if you get the cheapo bungee cords, there's a tendency that they can snap on you, and that can be a bit dangerous, especially if your eyes are anywhere near when that happens. So these are steel core, so that way they won't break on you. They hit a max point, basically, and then they're also adjustable. You can push them up through and kind of change the size of them to pretty much whatever size you need. You can go super short like that, or you can go up to, a couple feet. So I like these bungee cords a lot. They work really well when you're setting up a tarp and things like that. So I just have my wool blanket here. Like I said, this is just for like a day out doing some bushcraft. So you lay this out on the ground to do whatever, and then you kind of pack it up at the end of the day. Very easy kit. You can probably pack it all up in 5 minutes. So it's a very simple kit. I like it because it also doesn't have any plastic on it. It's a very nice thick, I'm not sure if it's canvas, it seems to be canvas, but it's very, very thick, and I like that. It's got steel, aluminum buckles and system on it, but, as long as they're metal, that's good enough for me. I really like that compared to plastic because they don't hold up, they break. So on the top, I just have my PLS K1. The only reason I have it on here and not on my belt is just so I could show you guys a little bit easier. I've burned this thing out to death. Everybody knows I love it. Think it's great. It also comes in with a ferro rod attached with it. So that's my primary fire starting right there. And then we'll get into my secondary combustion kit when we get into the kit here in just a second. So that's my main knife. And then I also have in my pocket at all times, I have another pocket knife. I have a Bic lighter, and also have a Zippo. So, I have a lot of fire stuff on me at all times. So first, I'll go ahead and show you this way. It's got a little, basically, I guess, strap to keep everything tucked in if the flap's open. And that has the same buckle type closure that you lift it up. Now, I don't have it in place right now, but I'll show you in a second the waterproofing that this has. Once I take all the stuff out, I'll show you what that is. I don't have it in there right now, or it's in there, but it's tucked down because obviously it's not raining right now, so I didn't feel like it was important. Plus, I want to show you guys the kit a little bit better. So basically, it's a very basic kit. I have my MSR Seagull, which I just did a video on, as well as the contents of that are on that video. My Guide Designs, just did a video on that. Great two containers, the only ones I would recommend, really. They're awesome. And then pretty much from there, I have two 30-foot hanks of paracord. I have some bank line, so I've got two different types of cordages. I have a cotton bandana, and inside of that cotton bandana is some Gorilla Tape. This is the small stuff. It's like $3 for a 30-foot roll of this stuff. Amazing. I actually use this, I prefer it over moleskin because I think it sticks better, honestly. I put some of this on my foot on a backpacking trip because I had kind of like a splinter that was dug into my foot, but I couldn't get it out, but I was still continuing to hike. So I just put some of this on there, and it kept it from aggravating my splinter for the rest of the day, and it actually stayed on. Even walking through creeks barefoot, taking a bath in the creek that night, it still stayed on there. So it's a great tape. The only stuff that would really hold up over time would be Gorilla Tape. Next, I just have my emergency. If it does rain while I'm out here and I don't include the tarp, I do have a 55-gallon drum liner, so that will keep me dry if I need to. Signal mirror, not necessary when you're going out for the day, but it's so light and small, figured why not. A lot of people don't really know how to use their signal mirrors. I think that's kind of a understated thing in the community is, you know, oh, I got a signal mirror, but you don't really know how to use it. Go ahead and read the back and learn how to use it, because it could save you one day. Next thing is just my fire kit. I do believe I've also gone over this in another video. Can't quite remember. I have some waxed jute twine in here. I have a video on this if you're interested. This is my last one in here, so I need to go ahead and make some more. Quadruple aught steel wool, brand new Bic lighter, Ranger bands, which are flammable, jute twine, chaga, a massive ferro rod with a handle that kind of sits on there. Brand new, doesn't even have the coating scraped off of it yet. Fresnel lens that needs to be cleaned off. Another smaller ferro rod, and in the bottom, it's full of char cloth. So, if you can't get a fire going with that, you're pretty bad off. If you can't get a fire going with this, then I would consider you carry a 20-minute road flare, because you're pretty inexperienced. Because these will burn for about 5 to 6 minutes apiece, so they're great. I love those things. They're definitely the best tinder I've come up with to date. If any of you guys have come up with something that's better, don't tell me cotton balls and petroleum jelly. I've heard that a million times. I don't think it's the best. So that's my fire kit right there. And then from there, I just have LED headlight, a compass, which is actually hooked to the side right here. So if I happen to drop it while I'm walking, I still have it. It has a movable bezel ring. So if you're doing a little bit of more skilled land navigation, you can do that. And then the last thing I have in here is hygiene. Not necessary. The only reason I have it in here is mainly for first aid purposes. I do have the cotton bandana. I do have the cargo tape. I do have a cloth sail needle. It's not in here right now. That is something I forgot. But I do believe there's a needle in here. Yeah, there is a needle in here. So that's kind of the reason I brought it, is because it's got a few things in here that I thought are kind of important. This is mainly for overnight, but I would go ahead and carry it for a day pack. That's why it's in here. Got a washcloth, sunscreen, toothbrush, toothpaste, a 9-foot by like 2-inch bandage, a wrap bandage, another one of those that's like 3 inches. I have some ibuprofen painkiller. I have a bar of soap. I have some latex gloves. I have some nail clippers. And then I have some Neosporin, I have some alcohol wipes, and I have some 4-inch bandages, a 4-inch by 4-inch piece of gauze, and some more smaller band-aids. So it's quite a packed up kit. And so I figured for the weight, you might as well take it. It's good to have hygiene out in the woods. So the reason I really like this particular pack right here is it's got a very good heavy-duty vinyl in it. And if you see, you can pull it out just like this. There's vinyl all inside, and then it has all this excess. So you put all your stuff in, and then you kind of fold this up at the top. Then you can fold this flap down right here. And then you can fold over these right here. And you have a very, very waterproof kit. Because that vinyl is not going to let water come in. And then if you've got all this over top and then the flap over it, your stuff's pretty much going to be bone dry no matter what. Even if you lay it on the ground, the vinyl, it won't let it soak through. So I really like that. I think that's the main reason why I chose to use this kit or this particular pack is because of its great waterproofing. That and it's very sturdy canvas. I like it a lot. The only thing I don't like about it is the straps on it are kind of cheaply made and they're kind of poor. I just don't like them. They're not very comfortable at all. So I'll be switching these out very soon. But, you know, that's pretty much the kit. That's about all I got to say. I think it's good to have a little bit more of a modular system. I think I'm going to go ahead and lean towards because that way you don't have to necessarily repack and pack up a kit every time you want to go out. You can take your day pack when you want to go out for the day, obviously. And then when you want to have that long-term kit, you take that day pack and you insert it into maybe a medium Alice pack or a large Alice pack that has the other things in it that make it a little bit more long-lasting kit, a little bit more longevity oriented, so that way you don't have to pack up a different kit every day. So these things are the basics, I think, for at least a day out. Have a little bit of emergency items. You have a knife, you have a way to start a fire, you have cordage, you have cover, and then we've got a bottle and a mess kit, and then beyond that you have duct tape, some cotton. Cotton's great for making char cloth, multiple ways to start a fire, signaling, hygiene, and then a large, not a large cutting implement, but a larger cutting implement so you can process larger firewood. So those are about the basics, I think. I'm not going to drag this video out very long. I think I've gotten my point across. So I hope you guys have a good day. Thank you for watching. Let me know if you have any questions or comments. I'll be happy to answer them. Just leave them in the comments or send me a message. So have a good day, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.